and continuously engage with it in a critical way. In other words, if we can have continuous, because I think just taking down the statue is not enough. We actually, we can't afford to forget that even when the statue is down, this institution was founded on racism. We need to remember it creatively.
Good afternoon, my name is Joshua Knott, and I just want to quickly speak to the point of white privilege. And I want to speak to those boys and girls from private boys and girls schools, who probably drive cars, who probably have a lot of time on their hands, that choose not to educate themselves about this university, and the fact that Cecil John Rhodes was a bigot, a racist, an exploitator. And if you believe in symbolism, you wouldn't see a swastika in the statue next to Freud. We cannot have a situation where we are constantly reminded about oppression on a daily basis at this institution. And I think these issues have been brought up continuously year on year. And one needs to understand why people feel the need to actually do what they do. So we can't just condemn people for throwing feces. If the institution actually listened to these concerns, people wouldn't feel the need to actually go and throw cuck on Cecil John Rhodes. So with that said, I also want to address the issue of the reasoning as to why we feel we need to honor this guy at UCT. The land that he gave UCT did not belong to him. The land that he gave was stolen land. And I would like to say that statue needs to be replaced with someone like Ashley Krim, who died for us as our people to study law. Not law! So I want to welcome you, I want to welcome on to the the president of the Student Representative Council. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been talking. We have said enough is enough. It is now also again to say enough is enough to the institutional racism that exists in this institution. The SLC in its meeting endorsed the call. Sorry. What are you doing? The SLC in its meeting endorsed the call from students to have the Cecil John Rhodes statue removed. It was a unanimous call. All SLC members agreed to that. But ladies and gentlemen, I think this needs to be a united effort. We need to be coming on as a unity, both with the academics and the students, in changing the institution. We cannot keep on talking when we send us and engaging. Engage, the time to engage has passed. We need to have tangible transformation. Okay. Hands. I saw you at the beginning. Two. Against the statue. The SRC this morning released a statement drawing the contrast between what just happened in 657s on the lower campus. Those students who voluntarily vomit on one another. How do you not read the distinction between something that is so unsanitary opposed to somebody throwing excrement against a statue? Secondly, with regards to the other community.
In this movement, we want it to be a united movement of students and staff members. We've also approached staff members who've been calling about the same thing. It doesn't make sense to have a movement by staff members and a movement by students. How is there no solidarity? So we're going to be meeting at 3 o'clock to establish a way forward. 3 o'clock, Leslie Social Forum, and we're going to name ourselves a movement of students from all backgrounds who believe, because it's not just the Cecil John Rhodes statue, it's racism all around. And it's not only taught by students, it's taught by staff members, by workers, by everyone. And we need to be united by it. And we hope that 2 o'clock will see students in Leslie Social. Thank you.
So the biggest thing that's been today has been that lots of people coming through, they've been venting situations, they've been complaining. leader solution. So, full disclaimer, I understand that some people who mentioned the original pioneer column, and I do support such a vote. However, I also believe in the principle of democracy, and I believe that the majority of students want the statue of rights removed. So therefore, that is what we must do at this university. The problem is that to try force this to the university council, how are we going to convince the university council to remove the statue? How are we going to convince the university council?
Why do we need their permission?
The majority of students want. So we need to find a way to show the majority of students what this needs. Someone needs to draft a petition. Someone needs to draft the petition, take it to the council, and force the council's hand to do the right thing. We need to force the council to take action. And that's why we need one petition, and everyone needs to sign this petition.
Those who care more value than the statue of Sassan Chambers.